Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries.
My name is Sylvia Hammarstrom of Skansen, Kennel, and we are located up in Sebastopol, California. I've been breeding these dogs since I was 10 years old, which is 70 years ago. I bred my first champions. The Schnauzer, there are three sizes, and the most common in Europe is what we call the Standard Schnauzer. It's a very, very old breed. It goes back 400 or 500 years, and it's been documented in paintings, so it's a fact. And what happened is the Germans and European farmers, they needed some help with rats. They didn't have rat poison like we have today. So they needed something to keep the rat population down, being that they were farms and they had grains and they had lots of rats. They found that the Schnauzer was the perfect size, and he was very good at doing it, as good as a cat. Cats would have a hard time with big rats. So that's how the breed came about. The farmers then realized they wanted something a little bigger, so that when they went to market with their produce, and they were not always rich enough to have horses, so they had dogs. And they found that if they used a Schnauzer and they got him a little bigger, then he could pull the merchants to the market. And then once they sold their chickens and grains, and they went to the pub, they could leave the money in a little bag next to the dog, and nobody would take their earnings because they are excellent guard dogs. And so that's how the Giant came about. To get the breed up in size, they used Dobermans. So you would see in the way back when, you would see black and tan Giant Schnauzers. Then used Great Danes, the black Great Danes, and that's how they, I think, established the color. They also used poodles, the standard poodle, because of its intelligence, the coat, the protective coat for the weathers. And the Schnauzer has a little bit of the poodle characteristic. He loves water, just like most poodles do. And they, of course, the intelligence of the standard poodles. So those are most the breeds. Then probably some local breeds, herding breeds, the Bouvier background, breeds like that. They're excellent herders. In fact, I think that's a drawback to a personal pet, because they have a tendency to herd and chase down things, which most breeds do, of course. But they'll they do very, very well at herding tests. They can be used for sheep herding. They have a tremendous endurance. Well, the standard is pretty basic. Strong top line, fairly high tail scent, like 1 o'clock. Good bite, good scissor bite. So that they, because they're used for police dogs quite a bit, and for search and rescue, and so they need a good bite. They weigh, in my opinion, the average female weighs around 75 pounds as an adult, and the average male weighs about 95. That doesn't mean that many of them go over, and there are many, many males that weigh up to 125. It calls for cropped ears and short tail, cropped tail, in the standard. However, because of Europe having changed their rules the last 15, 20 years and eliminated cropping, it's kind of spilling over to America now. And so Americans are picking it up, but in Europe, it's illegal to crop ears or tails. So all Schnauzers have long hanging ears and a long tail. In America, there is no rule for or against, so cropping is still most popular. My personal choice is I love the look of a Doberman or a Great Dane or a Schnauzer with pricked ears. I hate long tails for the simple reason they look and act like a sword. And so if they're the size of your coffee table and they're very friendly, so they're always wagging their tails, particularly violently when they see you, and off comes all the things on your coffee table, all your things on your night table. You have to worry about them getting in and out of cars. In today's with sliding doors, it's such a convenience not to worry about the tail who so frequently gets caught in the car doors. Well, personally, I'm a fanatic about a good health. So in my opinion, when you get a dog and you take good care of him and you feed him correctly and exercise him correctly and he has a good start in life, he should never have to see a veterinarian unless he has an accident, you know, get hit by a car or something. Of course you go to the vet, but there is no health problem in the breed. And to me, that's a big plus when you own a dog. You don't have to worry about hip dysplasia. You don't have to worry about skin problems, or they don't go blind early. They don't go lame. I couldn't give you a single disease that I would worry about in Giant Schnauzer. Not one. If he has to work, which he should do, he is fantastic in search and rescue. He is excellent in protection. He's really a natural guard dog. I don't encourage people to egg on their personal pets, because these dogs are smart enough when they're adult to know who their enemy is and who is somebody that they know. And so you'll find that by just their big size, black hair, covered eyes, people always think they can't trust the dog, that if they can't see their eyes, which is a psychological thing. But and the pricked ears, which it has in common, of course, with the Doberman. So people automatically respect a big black dog. And so you have protection built in already. And the dog is naturally so tuned in to you as a person that he will protect you against unusual things. They're naturals. You don't need to egg them on. If you like to do agility and you like to do Schutzhund, they excel in it. They're what the Germans call them, the professional Schutzhund dog. In other words, the trainer has to know a little bit, because the dog knows more than the trainer. Once you have a Schnauzer, you'll never want anything else. When you bring them in, which should be as puppies, everybody should start out with a puppy so the puppy learns your lifestyle. They're very keen on exploring their environment. They'll put their mouths on everything. They'll find your shoes, your socks, your bed, everything they can find, they'll pick it up and carry it around. And that is just their way of exploring their universe. So they outgrow it. They're not chewers. They don't ruin things to be difficult. They're just curious. So we supply our puppies with bones, regular bones, with what we call raw meaty bones. And they love it. They love the taste. And that keeps them busy, and they get nutrition, and they leave your shoes alone. The dog's lifespan is 10 to 12 years as most large breeds. However, if you feed them correctly and you don't let them get fat and you do exercise them, many, many of our customers tell us their dog just died and they'll be 15, 16 years old. All our dogs, every single one of them, gets nothing but raw, meaty bones. And that means they can eat like turkey. You could take the whole turkey and cut off the neck for one meal and a couple of thighs for the next meal and the carcass, the body, the chest cavity for the third meal. So then he gets everything he needs. Then you need to give him some organ meats like liver and heart, gizzards. And then we recommend that you give them a can of sardines in olive oil once or twice a week. We recommend eggs, raw eggs. Excellent. And then chicken, and then they can eat steak, of course. So it's a matter of shopping. If you start shopping, you can buy 40 pounds of chicken for half the price of commercial dog food, and it's 100% more nutritious. They're not an aggressive breed at all. You can bring any dog you like here, and our dogs would bark at them, sure, because they're different. But the dog fights are very rare. You'll have two females that are standoff between each other, and they mark it very clearly by putting their heads over each other's shoulder to show dominance. And if that happens, you kind of keep those separate because you don't want to stress them to live with somebody who they feel they have to dominate. But overall, I trust them. I trust them with everything. I think it's great when people take the time to train their dogs and to socialize them and take them with them. A lot of people are taking their dogs to work today. I think it's wonderful. I wish I could have done it, even if flying around the world with a dog wouldn't have been a very smart thing. But they like all dogs, they need to be well socialized. But what I also think is very important is when young puppies are 7, 8 weeks old and the owner comes to get them or the buyer comes to get them, that dog has only learned very little socializing from his mother and his litter mates, but he hasn't learned to speak dog language yet. He hasn't learned how to cope with big, strange dogs. And so that part of socializing is lacking in many, many pet owners. So what we do, we keep our pups till we don't let them go before 10 weeks, preferably 16 weeks. And they are then socialized with other puppies, with big dogs, with old dogs, and that will teach them things more than a person can. I feel they speak a dog language. And so many dogs don't speak their own language. And that's a handicap. So they come to the dog park and they can't speak their own language. And then they get frightened of the other dogs or they get aggressive with the other dog. A giant schnauzer like ours, it'll just trot through the park like, hi there, everybody. And I think that it's just completely natural. And why should you attack? There's no danger here. I don't have to protect myself. But then there are dogs in the park that will attack. And if you have a well-socialized dog, he's not going to fight right back. He's going to stand there and say, are you an idiot? Leave me alone or you're going to be in trouble. And then it's up to him whether it pursues into a big fight or not. But dogs have to learn to speak to each other too and respect each other. It's a great, great, great breed for all kids. I consider all ages are appropriate for them. I really do. And they're very good people who bring home children, newborns, even if they've been in the home for a while. They have a tendency to think that, oh, this is valuable to my owner, so I got to guard it. And they will almost immediately take over and guard your little baby. Elderly people is harder because they also lose their balance. They don't have much good balance when they get older. I'm 80 and I have 50 giant schnauzers, but I look where I'm going and that way I don't get knocked over. I got been knocked over several times in my lifetime by the dogs, but now I'm extra careful, that's all. They're very, very low maintenance in my own opinion. They need to be groomed about 3 times a year. Most people will clip them down, leave the leg hair and the beard and the eyebrows, which gives them their special look. So if you give them a bath every 2 months or every 3 months, give them a haircut, they're always going to look good. And everybody can do it themselves. And because grooming today, going to a grooming shop is quite expensive, just one visit at the groomer will pay for a clipper. And you get to sell one of those electric clippers, and then you clip your own dog. You may mess up the first couple of times and it looks a little jagged, but it's fun and you're going to get an expert at it and you're going to take pride in doing it. I will say one thing about the breed, which I find interesting, is it's a very intelligent breed. And I know everybody thinks their dog is intelligent, and most dogs are. But they are intelligent in the sense that they pick up on your emotions. So they make a very good companion. You can cry hugging them, you can laugh hugging them. You can, all your emotions you can act out with your dog. They want to be with you. So if you want to be inside, they want to be inside. If you want to be outside, they want to be outside. It's not the kind of dog you just lock out in your backyard and you sit inside and enjoy your cool air conditioner. They really are people dog. They really would like to climb right inside your body. They just want to be with you 24 hours. Ooh, yeah. I've been all over.